For instance, accidents. If somebody is passing through a street, within him the decree, the qadr, which has been written down by Allah, is that such a person has such physique and such habits and such, you know, inherited values and good points and bad points. So the possible lifespan would be from 50 years to 100, let's say, or 50 years to 70. And at the age of 30, he is crossing a street and he is hit by a car and dies. That is a different phenomenon altogether. So under qadr, when I mentioned this phenomena which we have been discussing, not the other phenomena. And yet there will be other phenomena also which will become involved. For instance, somebody gets a heart attack. He may have that heart attack right in a hospital where the best surgeon is available. Or he may have this heart attack in the middle of an ocean, traveling on a boat where no help whatsoever is available. The result would be different. So if somebody is praying for the life of such a person, Allah would so ordain that this accident, if it is an inborn accident, I mean decreed accident, should take place where he is immediately provided all help and the lifespan is extended. I mean, this is a very crude example, but many things of similar nature, of a milder nature maybe, can happen in everyday life. So the factors are not just limited to the one factor which I mentioned. What I mentioned was simply this, that the Creator, whatever has an inborn written lifespan for whatever He has created. And by that I meant, and now you have understood, I hope, that the physique of everything, whether he is that thing is inanimate or animate, has a certain limitation. That limitation is already coded into him or it. And that limitation cannot be crossed. But within the maximum and minimum, there would be the possibility of a little play. And that is the play which can be influenced by prayers. Please, I'm sorry, yes, I should have given you time off before him, but I forgot. Please.
I'm wondering if I may venture to reconcile the hadith that Jabir Abdul Rashid has quoted. Can it be interpreted that Hazrat Mahmoodi Akram Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam instructed all his followers not to rub in the fact that he was superior to the other prophets in front of the followers of such prophets?
But that's not possible. Then that version could not be reconciled with the other version where he mentioned Hazrat Moses himself by naming him. You know, the question involved was whether he was superior to Moses or not. And in that particular case, the followers of Moses were hurt if it was mentioned categorically that he was superior to Moses. Now, instead of solving this issue, if he had declared that, "Do not declare me above any other prophet," that may mislead the Muslims to believe that he was superior to none. So why not remain limited to the problem at hand? Because we have a tradition or some other traditions which limit the problem, keep the problem limited to the incident. So there is no need to believe in this generalization.
So if it is generalized, if the prophet,
the followers of any other prophets are in your company, and you rub in the fact that Rasool Akram Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is superior to them, it could hurt their feelings in exactly the same way.
No, but that inference should be drawn from that incident. It is automatically drawn. But when instead of mentioning Hazrat Moses, who was the prophet in question, Ahl-Sallam makes a generalized declaration, it would most often mislead rather than lead you to the right thing. You see, this is why people, this is apparently a very misleading statement. And because the same incident is referred to in another version of a tradition, where Ahl-Sallam directly mentions Moses and does not mention all other prophets, so this could not have happened at one and the same time. This is why I reject these words and prefer those words.
I understand.
Read those words again, then you will understand why I hesitate to believe that these were the words. The last part.
मुझे अंबिया कराम में से किसी पर फजीलत ना दो.
This is.
And then
this is very likely that that time Ahl-Sallam should have mentioned मुझे किसी पर फजीलत ना दो. While in other place he himself has mentioned it categorically that I am above every other prophet. And again another very important thing, the following incident, which is related in the same tradition, picks out Hazrat Moses himself alone. So these words do not fit into the following version, with the following version at all. When he said لَا تُفَضِّلُونِي or لَا تُخَيِّرُونِي عَلَىٰ مُوسَىٰ, he mentioned another incident, another fact, which would occur at the time of resurrection, which was particularly related to Hazrat Moses and no other prophet. So if you accept those words, there will be no relationship between the following incident. He must have mentioned Hazrat Moses in the first instance, because the whole statement ended up in giving us reason why, and that also poses other problems for us. It's a very difficult tradition as a whole to reconcile with some other traditions and with the holy some verses of the Holy Quran. So why to add to the problem unnecessarily? I mean, if those words are proved to be the words, then we'll have, of course, we'll have to exercise our intelligence to the maximum limit to bring about a reconciliation. I agree, but why call bother unnecessarily? Why call trouble unnecessarily? Yes, please. Do you want to tell me that the time is over, or want to ask?
No, please. We cannot reconcile with the meaning of the ideas, because it goes clearly against the Quran as well. Khatiman Nabiyin, Sayyidul Ulzayala.
Of course, sir.
All of those, so there must be something wrong with this interpretation of this.
These words?
Yes.
Yes? He is not blaming you. He don't say you have just concocted the whole thing. Don't take personal offense. You see, you have offended him. He thinks that you are alleging that he has just now fabricated the words. No. Yes, please.
This should be taken out of the
No, you shouldn't. Whatever has been included in the old books must remain there and must pose a challenge for those who want to investigate and exercise their intelligence. The fact is, the various versions should be compared with each other, and through the internal order of logic, one should